Weddings are usually happy occasions where everyone feels comfortable in the presence of their closest friends and beloved family members. Unfortunately, Anthony and Emma's wedding was not quite like that. Prejudiced, the bride's father humiliated the groom's mother because she was a cleaner, when she reveals her wedding gift and surprises everyone. Hello, my friends. I am Linda, and this is the Linda's Stories channel. I hope you enjoy this story. Emma's father, a young and sweet girl, has always been an extremely protective parent, especially since she is an only child. He set strict rules such as not allowing her to come home late, and he educated her with discipline. When Emma expressed her desire to go to college, her father made a special request, that she not get involved in romantic relationships during her studies. At that time, Emma agreed to her father's request, understanding that he acted out of an excess of zeal and concern. She valued her close and respectful relationship with her father and was willing to follow his guidance, since, in reality, she had no interest in meeting someone romantic at that time. At the time, Emma was 18 and about to enter college. She always had a close and loving relationship with her father, although he was extremely protective. He was a middle-aged man, about 45 years old, and always concerned about keeping his daughter safe and well cared for. The first few months at college were a mix of emotions for Emma. She was excited about the new stage of life, but also felt the pressure of her father's expectations. He had placed special emphasis on his request that she not date during her period of studies, worried about possible distractions and a loss of focus. Although Emma understood her father's concerns, she also longed for independence and the freedom to explore her own life. She was determined to succeed in college, but at the same time felt curious and an increasing desire to experience romance and connect with other people. While settling into college, Emma focused on her studies and making new friends. She got involved in extracurricular activities, participated in social events, and met interesting people. However, she always kept the promise she made to her father to not get romantically involved. However, as time went on, Emma began to question the reason behind her father's prohibition. Then, Anthony, who attended the same college, sparked her curiosity and interest. The two would occasionally meet in the hallways and at university events, and Emma felt a special connection with him. She saw and admired Anthony's determination, and felt he was someone who could share her goals and dreams. Over time, the friendship between Emma and Anthony deepened. They shared many moments together, laughed, and discovered an ever-growing closeness. Their romance blossomed subtly yet undeniably. Emma found herself increasingly emotionally involved, but also felt torn and guilty for disobeying her father's request. Her mother was her best friend, and they shared all their secrets when they gathered for coffee or to watch a TV show. They did this almost every weekend together, as a kind of ritual. Emma never kept secrets from her mother, but knew that her innocent romance might disappoint her father. For almost 2 years, Anthony and Emma were involved without hardly anyone knowing. But at a certain point, they knew they could no longer hide their relationship, especially because of a proposal Anthony was about to make. He was madly in love with the young woman and had already planned their entire life together. He felt she was his true soulmate. Anthony had meticulously planned the perfect moment for the marriage proposal. He chose a starry night when the sky was filled with bright, luminous points. The atmosphere was soft and romantic, and he knew it would be an unforgettable moment for both him and Emma. Filled with anxiety and excitement, Anthony invited Emma for a nighttime stroll. She was radiant with happiness, with no idea what was about to happen. As they walked hand in hand through the streets lit by city lights, she noticed that Anthony had stopped walking and was staring intensely at her. Confused, Emma asked if everything was okay with him or if he was feeling ill. Her heart began to beat faster as she observed Anthony's face reveal the tremendous anxiety and concern he carried with him. She held his hand affectionately, showing support and curiosity about what was to come. So, in that magical moment, Anthony nervously licked his lips and, with a trembling smile, knelt down in the middle of the street. His eyes sparkled with love and anticipation as he delivered his beautiful, rehearsed speech, pronouncing each word with sincerity and emotion. "I know we have only been dating for 2 years, but the love I feel for you is so intense and deep that I can barely wait another minute to start planning our life together. You are the person who fills all the empty spaces in my heart, my best friend, and the woman I wish to spend the rest of my life with. Emma, will you marry me? As Anthony expressed his deepest feelings, a mixture of emotions took over Emma. Her heart was filled with joy, gratitude, and a love so intense it seemed to overflow. She couldn't contain her happiness and began to laugh, repeatedly letting out an enthusiastic, "Yes!" Her eyes sparkled as she looked at the beautiful engagement ring Anthony had placed on her finger. The glittering stone captured the starlight and reflected the glow of the love they shared. At that moment, Emma knew their relationship could no longer be a secret. It was a promise of commitment and union, a step toward a future together filled with love and happiness. However, he notices that the expression on his fiancée's face gradually fades, and he soon asks, "You're thinking about your parents, aren't you? Why can't I meet them?" Emma felt embarrassed and lowered her head, replying that everything would be resolved soon and everyone would be together. The following weekend, Emma prepared to reveal the big secret to her mother. She organized a pleasant afternoon with cake, coffee, and their favorite TV show on, creating a relaxed and welcoming atmosphere for the conversation that was about to happen. She knew her mother had always been the most understanding and supportive, and she trusted in her ability to comprehend and accept the situation. With a racing heart, Emma began to unveil her great secret to her mother. She shared how she was deeply in love with Anthony and how they had kept their relationship a secret for so long. Her mother was shocked by the news and asked her daughter to start from the beginning, telling all the details. As the words flowed from Emma's mouth, her mother realized she had made a fatal mistake in prohibiting any kind of dating for her daughter. She understood that in trying to protect her, she had deprived her of experiencing the love and happiness that now sparkled in her eyes. The mother saw the joy stamped on Emma's face as she talked about Anthony, and it profoundly touched her heart. When Emma finished telling her story, her mother had tears shining in her eyes. The concerned young woman, seeing the tears, asked if she had hurt her mother that much, but to her surprise and relief, her mother replied that those tears were of happiness. With a choked voice, her mother said she had always wished to see her daughter truly happy, and now realized that the fiancé, Anthony, seemed to be an excellent young man. She expressed her joy in seeing her daughter involved in such a beautiful and sincere love. With her mother's positive reaction, Emma felt a weight being lifted from her shoulders. She smiled and hugged her mother with gratitude and affection, knowing she had the support of the most important person in her life. Her mother then suggested that a grand dinner be arranged to celebrate the union of Emma and Anthony. Upon hearing this, Anthony mentioned that he could hardly wait for the big moment, and together they began preparations for the big day. However, when Emma's father learned of all this, he became furious. He had told his daughter not to date, and now the situation was agonizing, and he couldn't sleep at night, having to wait for the morning of the next day to process and accept the dinner. After all, he more than anyone was curious to find out who the elderly woman was. Within his large and luxurious office, the father tried to use the tools at his disposal to look for information on Anthony and even check if he had a criminal record. Finally, the day of the dinner had arrived. The atmosphere was tense and uncomfortable as the dinner began. Anthony entered the living room alongside Emma, introducing himself to her parents with a confident smile on his face. However, the concerned expression on the bride's father's face was evident, indicating that something was not right. As soon as Anthony sat down at the table, Emma's father wasted no time and started an incisive questionnaire. He asked the groom about his identity, his origin, and his family. Anthony, well-dressed and ready to make a good impression, tried to talk about his personal and professional achievements, but was interrupted by Emma's impatient father, who demanded specific information about his family. Anthony maintained his composure in the face of Emma's father's hostile attitude. Calmly, he said that his father had passed away when he was young and that his mother had raised him alone. The sadness in the eyes of the bride's father upon hearing this information was noticeable, but he was not satisfied and continued to press for more details about Anthony's family. The young man knew that his answer was not what Emma's father wanted to hear. He realized that dinner was about to become a real disaster even before it had begun. With the determination not to expose his family's personal story without his mother's consent, Anthony responded politely, "Sir, I'm sorry, but my mother doesn't like me discussing her past. If you want to know more details, you will have to ask her personally." Anthony's vague response made Emma's father even more suspicious. The man began to wonder what kind of secrets this elderly woman could be hiding. Throughout the dinner, he tried to extract information respectfully and delicately, seeking to learn more about Anthony's family. However, the groom subtly dodged the questions, maintaining his calm and polite demeanor. The bride's father's frustration grew with each failed attempt to obtain concrete answers. He lost his patience, banging on the table and shouting in an outburst of rage and despair. His words echoed in the room as he questioned Anthony's integrity and accused him of hiding something. "How can you marry someone who won't tell us about his family? What are you hiding?" said Emma's father. Emma was completely shocked by her father's explosive behavior. She couldn't understand how he could act in such a way, questioning the character and integrity of her fiancé. She rose from the table, staring directly into her father's eyes, and asserted firmly that Anthony owed no explanations to anyone, and that her father should stop looking for problems where there were none. A discomfort took over the table, leaving a heavy silence hanging in the air. The tension was palpable, and each family member was wrapped up in their own thoughts and emotions. The dinner that should have been a time for celebration and unity had turned into a draining family conflict. The father of the young girl grew increasingly irritated, but before he could say anything further, Emma stood up from the table and began walking towards the door. The daughter stated that she did not depend on him to get married, and that she could manage on her own, refusing all the money the family was going to give for a big wedding celebration. She also mentioned that Anthony was the only man Emma trusted, leaving her father extremely uncomfortable. Her mother, who had tried to keep the peace at all times, looked with a look of disgust at her husband and said, "All I asked of you tonight was to have an open mind, and if we lose our daughter now, due to your stubborn nature..." From that day on, the once perfect family was now completely shattered, and the man would be alone from there on. He got up early and went to work. When he arrived at the office, the only person there was the elderly janitor, who always arrived before the other employees. That morning, the janitor saw her boss's face and immediately knew the man was troubled. She stopped what she was doing and asked, "Sir, what's wrong?" Over decades, they exchanged brief greetings, and Emma's father valued her dedication and efficiency at work. He looked at the janitor and said, "Do you have children?" The woman's face broke into a smile, and her response came almost instantly. "Yes, sir, I have a son whom I am very proud of." Emma's father quickly retorted, eager to talk about his problems and desperately seeking advice. "I have a daughter, and until last night I was also proud of her. Then last night I met her fiancé for the first time and I don't trust him. What can I do? I'm trying to protect my family, but now my wife and daughter won't talk to me." The cleaning lady placed her hand on his shoulders and with a wise look replied, "Once we become parents, everything we do in our lives is for our children. But at a certain point in life, we must understand that the people who were once little children are becoming adults, responsible for their own decisions and deserving of our trust." Emma's father felt extremely comforted and thanked the cleaning lady for the advice. After finishing his shift, he tried to call his wife and daughter, but no one answered his call. He began to see how empty and lonely his life would be without his two favorite people in the world. He vowed to make amends with his family and would not rest until he did. What would he have in this life if not for his family? He tried to buy gifts for them and make reservations at restaurants, but neither of them showed up. After the incident at dinner, Emma felt the need to talk with her father and clarify the feelings that were overwhelming her. She walked to his room, knocking gently on the door before entering. Upon finding him sitting in an armchair staring into the void, she noticed that something had changed in his expression. What surprised Emma the most was her father admitting a mistake, something she had never witnessed before. His tone of voice was softer and calmer than usual, conveying a vulnerability she had never imagined seeing in him. She approached cautiously, sitting down in a nearby chair. Emma's father began to talk, revealing a story unknown to her until then. He talked about the hard times they faced when she was just a little girl. He described how he worked in a clothing factory and how he and her mother lived paycheck to paycheck, struggling to provide the best for the family. However, one day the factory closed unexpectedly, leaving them helpless and full of fear about how they were going to sustain themselves. He continued, sharing the moment he broke the news to Emma's mother, and how they cried together, filled with uncertainties. But in the midst of despair, he found the courage to start his own business, fighting for success and providing his family with the life they deserved. Emma was speechless, absorbing every detail of the story that had never been shared before. With tearful eyes, she finally understood how much her parents had done for her, the sacrifice and determination they had shown in ensuring her happiness and comfort. At that moment, everything made sense to her. She realized that nothing else mattered to her father besides his family. He was willing to swallow his pride, admit his mistakes, and do whatever was necessary to see his daughter happy. This revelation brought a new perspective on the situation, and she felt the unconditional love that existed between them. Moved, Emma reached out and held her father's hand. No words were needed at that moment, as a deep understanding passed between them. A significant silence permeated the atmosphere, reaffirming the love and the indissoluble bond between father and daughter. Emma then explained to her father to forget that dinner and that he should give a chance to truly get to know Anthony, and also said that she would not receive any money from the family to help with the wedding, that it would be a project of the young couple. Of course, her father agreed and could not hide his happiness and tearful eyes upon hearing that his daughter would accept him back. From that moment, their relationship gained a new dimension. Emma felt immense gratitude for everything her father had done for her, and he, in turn, embraced the opportunity to rebuild trust and the relationship with his daughter. Later, they had a small ceremony as they did not accept money from the father and paid for the entire celebration out of their own pockets. But it was all worth it just to see Emma walking down the aisle, wearing the same veil that her mother had worn, as a tribute for all the support she had given, moving everyone present at the party. Emma's father approached Anthony to give a strong hug to his future son-in-law and say that everything was fine and that he was welcome in the family, as long as he made his daughter happy. The young man was even disconcerted by the warm reception and thanked him sheepishly. An elderly woman who was observing the scene with a smile on her face approached and said, "I am Anthony's mother and I'm very happy to be part of this family." And the father's reaction was one of shock. He questioned if it was some kind of joke, since he was face to face with an elderly janitor from the building whom he always ignored. But before the humble lady could say a word, Emma's father interrupted. "How can my daughter marry the son of a janitor? How will they survive? Where will they live? This is unacceptable. It all makes sense now. That's why Anthony was hiding secrets about his family." But before the prejudiced father could say anything else, Anthony's mother, with calmness and dignity, interrupted the bride's father and said to the newlyweds, "Anthony and Emma, I am very happy about your union. God knows how I wish my husband and Anthony's father could be here, because he also dreamed of this moment." And then she revealed a surprise to the newlyweds. "Anthony, your father received a very good compensation for the time he worked at an important company, and for years he saved that money wisely. Before he died, he asked me to use this money to help in your future." Anthony's mother handed an envelope to the couple, embracing them with tears in her eyes. She added, "I wish you happiness and that love never departs from your home and your hearts." The money Anthony's father had left for his son was more than enough to buy a good property for the couple. She quickly approached the bride's father and whispered in his ear, "Sir, throughout my life I have learned that a person's worth is not found in their job or social status, but in their character and the love they can offer. My son is a wonderful man, and I'm sure that he will make Emma very happy. Happiness is not measured in money or titles, but in shared smiles and true love." The words of the elderly woman penetrated deep into Emma's father's heart. He reflected on his own attitudes and prejudices, realizing that he had been wrong all along. He apologized to Anthony's mother and the young couple, promising to support them in their marriage and their life together. The elderly cleaning lady, with a gentle smile, hugged Emma's dad and said, "Life is full of surprises, and sometimes you need to look beyond appearances to find true happiness." And so the story took a new direction. Emma's father learned to value people for who they are, not what they seem to be. And the elderly cleaning lady became an important figure in the family's life, bringing wisdom and humility. He knew that if Anthony had the character of his parents, his daughter would be happy and safe for the rest of her life. Then he raised his glass and said aloud to the small crowd, I would like to make a toast to all the members of our family. Welcome. If you enjoyed, please give it a like and subscribe to the channel. Leave a comment with a number from 1 to 5 to let us know how much you liked the story. Also, watch the video that is currently on your screen. See you soon.